大家好，我是 Tiffany 啊，今日咧就想同大家做一集咧名人英语嘅，而今日咧想讲嘅名人咧就系依个 Maria Sharapova。即是一個舒拉保娃的英文，大家知道她最近就在32歲的年齡就宣布退休啦。 So she has announced that she will retire at the age of 32， 即她32歲就已經宣布從這個運動員生涯退休了。那你就聽一下這個在俄國出世在美國長大的女運動員的英文。那不知道大家對舒拉保娃的認識有多少呢？我只知道她拿了很多個 Grand Slams， 即是大滿貫，亦都係即係因為可能佢好靚女啦，咁就大家都好注意佢啦，同埋咧佢成日喺賽事之中咧都有好多 grunts 同 screams 嘅。咁啊，佢有一個 video 裏邊咧就講到有啲即係記者啦，就去佢屋企嗰度咧去採訪，睇下佢屋企有幾靚嘅。咁啊，依條 video 咧就係講一樣嘢啦。咁就我覺得好好睇嘅，我自己就睇曬啦。咁大家可以一齊睇啦。因為依個 video 有啲長咧，我就會抽取一部分同大家講解嘅。
Hello, AD. I'm Maria Sharapova, and welcome to my home. I love homes that have an indoor and outdoor feel, and I think the light plays a big part into this home's atmosphere. In my previous home, I had a lot of colorful, a lot of greens and pinks, colors of art.
咁首先佢就話啦 ，Hello AD, I'm Maria Sharapova and welcome to my home. Hello AD, I'm Maria Sharapova and welcome to my home. 咁啊 ，Hello AD 即係嗰個採訪個台啦，或者雜誌啦。I'm Maria Sharapova， 我就係舒拉保娃啦。And welcome to my home， 歡迎你哋嚟到我屋企噃。咁咧，當然啦，佢可以話 welcome to my house 嘅。咁但係大家知道 home 就係一個家 ，house 係一間屋啫。咁啊，梗係 home 係温暖啲啦。跟住佢就講咩咧 ？I love homes that have an indoor and outdoor feel, and I think the light plays a big part into this home's atmosphere。佢就話咧，我好中意一啲嘅屋企啦，佢哋咧又有好多室內嘅嘢，又有好多室外嘅嘢嘅。That have an indoor and outdoor feel。咁好多同學咧以為 feel 呢個字咧，就梗係一見到咧就覺得佢係一個 verb 啦。但其實佢都可以做 noun 嘅喎。咁即係 let's say 例如你話 this picture has an outdoor feel。咁即係話哇睇到咧係一個 outdoor 嘅一幅圖嚟嘅喎。咁都會用 feel 呢個字做 noun 嘅。And I think the light plays a big part into this home's atmosphere。佢就話咧，我覺得咧燈光咧對依一間屋嘅氣氛起咗好大嘅作用嘅，所以咧佢就話 the light plays a big part into this home's atmosphere。咁冇乜太大特別啦，咁大家知道 atmosphere 除咗可以講我哋嘅大氣層之外，就可以講咧嗰個氣氛啦。咁跟住佢就講到啦 ，In my previous home, I had a lot of colourful, a lot of greens and pinks, colours of art。咁即係咧，佢就話咧喺佢之前嗰間屋企啦，咁依度嘅屋企咧，據我所知就係 L.A. 啦，咁可能都係喺 L.A. 嘅，總之就係佢之前嗰屋企。咁所以大家講之前早前嗰個咧 ，in my previous home, my previous boyfriend, my previous girlfriend， 即係我前度啊，咁其實你都可以用 previous 依個字啦，或者 at my previous school， 咁就喺我之前間學校等等啦。I had a lot of colourful, a lot of greens and pinks。佢就話咧，我有好多嘅 colourful 嘅咩咧，佢就冇講完嘅依句説話。咁我哋有時講講下嘢咧，都會停咗就講繼續噶嘛。咁所以咧，呢度 colourful 其實佢係想講可能類似 furniture 之類啦。咁啊，跟住啦，佢就補充啦，就咩叫好 colourful 嘅 furniture 咧？佢就話 a lot of greens and pinks, colours of art。佢話有好多嘅綠色啦，有好多嘅粉紅色啦，有好多嘅藝術嘅顏色嘅。咁可能大家就會諗啦，點解依度無端端個 greens 會加 s 㗎 ，pinks 會加 s 㗎？咁原來咧，你一路睇落去咧就會明白啦。因為舒拉保娃屋企佢有好多唔同種類嘅綠色，唔同種類嘅粉紅色，咁所以其實佢就可以講 a lot of greens, a lot of pinks， 可以咁樣講啦。
And now I'll show you my living room. So this is one of my favorite rooms in the home. I would say I spend a lot of time entertaining guests and all my close friends and Christmas Eve gatherings. It screams indoor-outdoor living in the summertime. All the windows are opened up and we have barbecues outside. There's nothing formal in this house, so everyone kind of goes about every room and hangs out.
跟住佢就話啦 ，Now I'll show you my living room。我而家咧就會俾你睇我嗰個大廳啦。咁 living room 咧，通常你好容易記啊，就係因為你喺屋企裏邊咧，多數嘅時間都係 spend 喺你個大廳啦。應該一般人咁，所以咧佢就話 living room 就係個大廳啦。Now I'll show you my living room。咁 now I'll show you 咧，大概個意思就係咁，我而家咧就會咁樣嘅意思嘅。Now I'll show you my living room。So this is one of my favorite rooms in the home。咁依間咧就係我喺屋企裏邊咧最中意嘅房之一啦。I would say I spend a lot of time entertaining guests。我咧就花好多時間咧去招待我嘅賓客嘅 ，entertaining guests， 招待我嘅賓客。咁所以 I would say I spend a lot of time entertaining guests， 即係話咧我花好多時間招待賓客啦。Entertain 係招待啦 ，guests 就係咧。超過一個嘅賓客嘅，咁大家咧可能都會覺得依個比較難讀啊，依個字。咁如果覺得難讀咧，其實你淨係讀兩個 s 就得啦，唔使讀 sts 啦。咁就係 guests，entertaining guests， 就係即係招待賓客啦。咁大家試下讀咯噃。And all my close friends and Christmas Eve gatherings。咁佢依度咧就話咧，佢咧就唔單止招待嗰啲賓客喎，亦都招待佢啲好親密嘅朋友啦。And all my close friends and Christmas Eve gatherings。佢亦都喺度咧同嗰啲朋友咧相聚嘅 gatherings 啊相聚啦。咁幾時相聚啊？咁當然就係一個平安夜啦 ，Christmas Eve gatherings 咁樣。咁你聽到佢個感覺咧就係、是，當然佢可以話 have Christmas Eve gatherings 啦，但係佢講得好隨意、好隨性嘅，就好似諗到咩就講咩咁樣嘅。It screams indoor outdoor living in the summertime。 佢就話咧，依一度咧就完全展現咗啊，就係喺室內同室外嘅生活啦。喺特別喺夏天嘅時候，咁咧佢就話用咗 screams 呢個字嘅，佢咧就用咗 screams 呢個字嘅。咁點解用 screams 呢個字咧？就係即係好充分展現到，好強烈咁展現到咁嘅意思。咁就唔係大嗌嘅意思嘅。咁所以咧佢就。係啦，用咗依個字其實都有用嘅，即係有少少似一個擬人嘅講法。All the windows are opened up。佢話咧好多嗰啲窗咧都開曬啦，咁所以你知道啦，明白點解係又室外又室內啦，因為嗰啲窗開曬咁啊見到啲光啦，係咪 ？We have barbecues outside. There's nothing formal in this house. Everyone kind of goes about every room and hangs out。佢就話咧，依間屋裏邊咧係冇一啲好正式嘅嘢嘅噃，因為咧每個人咧都係周圍走啦 ，goes about every room 咁啊。goes about every room， 即係喺唔同嘅房間穿插啦。And hangs out， hangs out 咧就有一種咧好好 chill 嘅感覺啦，好輕鬆嘅感覺啦，就係中意周圍去邊度都得嘅，即係喺度即係 spend 佢哋嘅 time 啦咁樣。
These two pieces， they are vintage， but they are extremely comfortable to sit on。
These two pieces， they are vintage。啊，依兩件咧，佢哋係以前整開嘅 item 啦。咁所以你可以話古董啦 ，they are vintage。咁 vintage 呢個字咧，依度就係一個 adjective 啦。But they are extremely comfortable to sit on。They're extremely comfortable to sit on。佢話咧，依啲咁樣嘅凳咧，就係坐落去好舒服嘅噃。咁 comfortable 呢個字咧，好多同學都讀錯啦，就讀咗 comfortable 咁樣嘅。其實唔係四個音節嘅，係三個音節 comfortable。comfortable 嗰個道理咧，就好似嗰個蔬菜一樣啦。咁蔬菜你唔會讀 vegetable 嘅，嗱 vegetable。咁所以啦 ，comfortable vegetable。Okay。
I haven't seen this picture of Basquiat before. I think a lot of his images were in color, and this one was just very striking in black and white. And in this image, I just feel like it's so calm, but there's so much emotion internally. And he's holding the globe, which represents, for my eyes, the world of travel, which is a huge part of my life, and I get to see different parts of the world.
跟住咧，佢就有介紹咧佢屋企嘅畫啦。佢就話啦 ，This one was just very striking in black and white, and in this image, I just feel like it's so calm. 佢就話咧，依個咧，依一幅畫啦，佢就用咗一個 adjective 去形容嘅，就係 striking 一個字啦。咁 striking 咧就係令人震撼嘅意思啦。In black and white， 因為咧點解震撼啊？因為咧黑白色嘅喎。In black and white， this picture is striking. It's in black and white. In this image, I just feel like It's so calm。 佢就話咧，依幅畫咧真係咧好平靜喎個感覺。It's so calm, but there's so much emotion internally。 佢就話咧， 雖然係平靜，但係呢幅畫咧，其實係內裏咧係有好多嘅情緒喺度啦。Internally 就係一個內裏嘅情緒啦。There's so much emotion internally， 有好多嘅內在嘅情緒啦。咁當然你講外在咧就係 external，internal，external。咁呢兩個咧個 ex 同 in 呢兩個嘅 prefix 一個前缀咧，大家要搞清楚啦。跟住佢就有講到話呢一個幅畫係 He's holding the globe, which represents for my eyes the world of travel。咁呢度咧我都唔詳細講啦，即係主要係講緊呢幅畫嘅一啲嘢啦，就話即係會表示咗或者代表咗旅行啦之類嘅嘢啦。
We host a lot of summer barbecues at this table we custom built. It was inspired by a table I saw at a Japanese store。
跟住佢就話啦。We host a lot of summer barbecues at this table we custom built。佢話咧，依件嘅台啦，依一張台咧就係訂造嘅，就係 custom built， 即係訂造啦。This table we custom built。Okay。It was inspired by a table I saw at a Japanese store。咁咧，舒拉寶娃咧就話日本嘅文化咧係俾咗佢好多靈感啦，去砌依一個嘅屋企出嚟嘅。咁所以 it was inspired by a table I saw at a Japanese store。
And I loved the shapes of it. I loved having one long bench where everyone can cozy up, and then chairs around it. And we also get to close this roof, patio roof in a sense. So when it's really sunny, you have a lot of beautiful shade.There's a lot of giggling going out here. There's a lot of rosé, a lot of great barbecues. Yeah, this is the summer spot in the house.
跟住佢就講到點解自己咁中意張台啦。I loved the shapes of it. I loved having one long bench where everyone can cozy up, and then chairs around it. And we also get to close this roof.咁咧佢就話咧，點解佢咁中意張台咧？就係話佢中意嗰個嘅形狀啦。I loved the shapes of it. I loved having one long bench. 咁 bench 咧，大家都要識嘅。依個就係通常公園嗰啲長凳啊，或者屋企嘅長凳都得嘅。總之係要長嘅凳咧，就叫 bench 噶啦。我醒起咧有一個道具咧，可以同大家講，就係依個啦。咁依個咧就係我哋課室咧會攞嚟清潔噶啦。咁我覺得幾好用嘅，佢叫 bench spray。咁點解叫 bench spray 咧？相信都係咁解啦，就係因為攞嚟清潔一啲長凳又得啦。咁當然 by extension 就係可能嗰啲台啊都得啦。我覺得依個好香啊，大家可以去 check out 下。係啊，好似植入式廣告咁，但係我覺得好正依個。係啦，嗰個味道我係非常之中意啦。好啦，跟住佢就講到喺 bench 嗰度可以做咩咧 ？One long bench where everyone can cozy up。佢話咧，每一個人咧都可以喺依一張凳嗰度咧，好舒服咁樣咧坐喺度嘅。Everyone can cozy up。當然大家可能咧 cozy 呢個字就係識得 adjective 噶，但係原來咧我哋好舒服咁樣窩喺度坐咧，都可以講 everyone can cozy up。I can cozy up in this chair 嘅意思就即係話我可以好舒服咁坐喺度啦，咁好似我而家咁樣 cozy up 啦。咁跟住咧，舒拉寶娃有講到佢屋企其他地方啦，例如有個 patio roof 啊，咁等等。咁其實呢啲都係喺外國咧先好多時好有錢嘅人啦，先會有嘅 luxury 啦。因為我哋喺香港都好難有呢啲 patio roof 啊，呢啲嘢啦。咁呢啲我就唔講啦。咁其餘咧都幾長嘅嗰啲嘢，因為佢其實整個 interview 我諗都有成廿分鐘咁長啦。咁我就精選咗一啲片段同大家講啫，因為我哋名人英語呢一個嘅環節咧，我諗都係15分鐘咯，盡量 keep down to 15分鐘嘅一個片的長度啦，咁你哋覺得依段片又點咧？學唔學到嘢咧？你哋學到嘅最中意嘅 expression 係邊個咧？咁我自己覺得咧，佢嘅英文都好自然，好好聽啦，咁就都好學到嘢嘅。特別係大家唔好成日覺得哦，依個字咧，我認知之中一定係動詞，亦都可以係名詞。咁本身係 adjective， 甚至佢可能。其實可以是 verb 的，咁當然啦，大家就一定要聽咗人哋去講呢啲嘅用法先至自己要用啦，就唔好自己去自創。如果你特別係英文唔係特別好叻嘅同學，你自創呢啲用法咧，咁好多時人哋就唔明你講乜噶啦。所以咧，我哋英文嘅學習咧就要建基喺模仿之上嘅，咁大家呢一點咧一定要記住啦。如果你中意呢段片嘅話咧，記住 like、share 同埋 subscribe 到我哋 YouTube channel， 記住要撳埋 subscribe 掣隔離個鐘仔咧，咁你就唔會錯過我哋將來嘅 updates 噶啦。
多謝呢位朋友 comment 我哋嘅 video 啦，咁我哋每個禮拜咧都會抽一個觀眾嘅 comment 貼糖嘅，因為多謝翻你哋 comment 我哋嘅 video。如果你想參加呢個所謂嘅貼糖比賽嘅話咧，你就可以喺 Instagram 去 tag 翻我哋個 Finnish Language Art 之後嘅 IG 啦，或者可以喺我哋 video 下邊 comment， 咁你就會有機會俾我哋貼糖噶啦。